Alright folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Legends of Amberland 2. Today, continued bug squashing. There are a lot of bugs in here. There are multiple floors of bugs. And I also discovered that there's a little information thing on every area of the game. It's like... God, what were they called in Might and Magic 3? Like, Korak's notes or whatever? Every area you'd go into, you'd have a little spade of text about them. I love it. Did not mean to full heal my party, but okay. Oh no, we're going for this fella. That time I did mean to full heal my party, bro. So many AoEs. So many AoEs. Damage. Oh, that's gonna be a fight. That's gonna be a me. Oh no, he's following me. I was not expecting this. You stay over there. Bro, oh no. Guys, we may have erred. Ever so slightly. Maybe not. Okay, this fight I'm gonna have the casters in back focus just to regain their mana, because these dudes aren't as nasty as certain other much larger variants. God, this place just goes on. Alright, so can you guys not come up here? Let's fight our way back out here. Very carefully. Bro, that's my wizard. Where's restoration? Oh, it's the wrong character. I'm like, why isn't Goldleaf restoring? It's Rove. Rove cannot heal, he can only hurt. Okay, well. And I guess we'll just attempt to continue here. Killing as we can. You little shit. Get out of here with your tiny little leggies and your fireballs and occasional death farts. Okay, how are we looking on food? We have actually plenty of food. That's good to know. Can't rest there's an enemy nearby. What? Oh, is there maybe... enemies nearby, you say? Perhaps a secret? No. Or more realistically, there's probably, like, this cave just goes on. Okay, here we go. This game's caves, I have to give them props. The caves in this do the same thing that caves in Wizardry 8 do, where their layout is very cavernous. It's not like a dungeon where it's, you know, discrete hallways and rooms and doors and stuff. No, this is, it's a fucking cave. I like that. I like that a lot. That is just buggery. There's friggin' three of those things back there. Let's... Oh my god. She can. Attack. Play song. I do like that the short rests give you the special abilities back, because that, in the case of Wizards and Devon, kind of gives characters a little bit of ability to shore up abilities a little bit. Let's do recovery. Okay, Devon, I actually want you to do Inspiring Ballad. Well, of course you don't die. Why would you die? That's just far, far too sensical. My god. Okay, now we gotta go back and have a real sleep. Okay, I gotta get this mesmerize off of Chunk. Him not being able to use his class abilities kind of irks him. This game does a thing that a lot of RPGs do, where they hit you with status effects that you have no way to cure, and they hit you with them early in the game, and you basically just have to suck it up and be like, yeah, sucks to suck. Not a fan of that. A lot of old D&D games did that with, like, poison. You know, you can get poisoned by anything in an old D&D game. It first or second level, but your cleric's not going to be able to cast Cure Poison until like 7th or 8th level. Because reasons. Alright. Has Rove been chain lightninging this whole time? It is just so expensive for the damage. It's half the damage of lightning. But to two things. I would rather just focus one down, I think. Mass heal. Regular heal. Okay. Regular heal. Lightning. Lightning. Melee. 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 Yeah, damn it. I didn't mean to mass heal again. That was wasted. What are you gonna do? Yeah, these are probably the enemies that the party was having a row about when we were trying to sleep earlier. Bard song, just to top up mana a little bit. Okay. Just a couple of these guys isn't super, super threatening. There we go. I'm just gonna have Devon heal everybody. We'll top off Sun Rawl because he is prone to dying. I got any of those? Oh my god. There are so many bugs in here. This is ridiculous. I mean, I like experience points, but good god. We gotta have some people ready to level. Yeah, we got everybody ready to level, which is good for our casters, because I think that means new spells for the back row. Probably some pretty substantial offensive magic. Not enough MP, the hell you say. Oh my god, alright, no. I can get them to separate into two discrete groups. We can probably handle this. Guys. Oh, you're just camping the corner? Okay, fine. You do that. You are not just camping the corner. Fuck. Alright, well. I guess we're in on this. Mass heal. Lightning bolt, death. Okay, there goes Rove, as one would expect. Thankfully, we do have recovery and some healing. Go fuck yourself, you dick beetle. Okay, let's go back. Are we looking on food? Man. This is just a branch of this cave. This is substantial. We still have this fight to do, but. I wouldn't mind like a something to help us resist all the elemental damage. Somebody in the comments mentioned that as you get further and further into this, you have to pay attention to elemental resistances and stuff, which I worry for. Okay. I'm honestly surprised that we haven't bumped into any secrets yet. Ring of Grand Sages. Ring of Grand Sages, plus 2 knowledge and confusion resistance. Oh, and apparently, so I did mention that I totally did sell Brunhilde's armor like a fucking doof. Naturally, the poor woman, everything's just taken from her. It's okay, she does well. Her survivability is a lot better now that I got her this protection armor, and I'm curious if it stacks, so like with 2 protections if she rolls 3 times. And if not, we can always replace the small shield with something a little bit chunkier. She's got, what, a point? I'm sure we could find something. Gotta get her some levitation boots or something. Okay. This fuckery. Well, no way. We've got, where were they? We got these assholes. Hey guys, I should have healed Rove. But I didn't, like a fool. No. Mass heal. Then a regular heal, because Rove is terrible. There we go. It's not like these fights are unmanageable, they're just testing our resources. If I am not picking this fight because, yeah, you see all of them fucking shuffling around, that's not gonna be just two beetles. We're gonna go back to town and restock and gain levels. And then we'll come back and kick the shit out of all of these things. Does this town have, it does. I was gonna say, does this town have an inn? Okay, what else you got? Just a basic shop, yeah, this is not great. We do have a bunch of money though, with which we could purchase a heavy shield 3, armor 6. Holy hell. That's really good, and I think she could use that, couldn't you? Yeah, she has the carrying capacity to actually use that. I think she'd probably have more armor. She already has more armor than Swell. Swell, bro, you're slacking. We gotta get you a better shield. We're not gonna do it here. This town doesn't even have a guild for leveling. My utmost disappointment. Can we see some banditos? We have many banditos. We have banditos for days. There's something over there. I see something out, like you see, are those, I think those might be spiders? Good Christ. We've got an old bandit, which means he's probably a hard ass, because if your trade is plying banditry and you get old, that means you're good at it because you haven't died yet. Right, is this the big town here? Info. Riverfell, the biggest trading town. All right. Wonderful. What was that other? There's also the mysterious magic shop. Oh, really? Things to blow my money on. All right. Fire blast, cone of ice, haste. This is a 2 levels for the front row. Hell yeah. And Devon, I guess. He got some extra spells. Adventurer's Ballad, Dexterity and Confusion Resistance. All right, what's Dex do for us? Hit bonus, evade bonus, and damage. That actually probably wouldn't be bad for him specifically. All right, what else we got? Cone of Ice, cold damage, fire blast. So these are better fireballs and cold balls. And, oh, but they're single target. Ew, that's... For the that compared to lightning, why would I do this? Although it is specifically fire damage, so we could target resistances. I actually wonder if these things are susceptible to cold magic. I've tried that. And this grants us haste plus 1 initiative, which just means we act a little bit quicker, which honestly isn't all that meaningful to me. Hey, we can finally remove mesmerize. There we go. And Devon got something. He got Cure Paralysis as well, which is nice. We can also apparently remove Fear, which I don't think we've seen Fear yet. But honestly, the Bard isn't too bad. They don't appear to be amazing, but they're not too bad. Hey, buddy. Oh, you've brought a message from my lovely wife. Please tell her I can't return just yet, and Igor should handle the harvest as he did last year. I've landed a very lucrative job here. Additionally, take this parcel and deliver it to my wife. I can't express my gratitude enough. You esteemed heroes, still find it in your hearts to run errands for us humble peasants. Not many heroes maintain such an attitude nowadays. Gained bag full of toys. I had plans to journey north, but those barbarians turned it into a headache. Quite literally, one of them knocked me unconscious with a club. If it weren't for the Bardachia patrol that came to my rescue, I have no doubt they would have dragged me to their caves. Rumor has it those barbarians maintain a cave to the north, where they imprisoned captives and forced them to clean up their filthy abode. Absolutely disgusting. Not even the honor of death by Snoo Snoo. Just cleaning. I have the spice, yes, the one and only exotic spice. That's right, and guess what? Today's your lucky day, it's on sale. Yeah, okay. I think we needed that for a chef and one of the cooks. Can we actually see what it is? Bag of toys, exotic spice, the fucking hot pepper. It's really magnificent in taste and flavor. It looks like a fucking, pixelated ghost pepper. Somebody's gonna burn their fucking face off. Okay. Welcome, welcome. Please, step inside. I'm selling flowers. Her name's Gardenia. Nice. I'm rather sentimental about my blooms, so I have a strict policy of selling them only to those who genuinely need them. Perhaps when they need them. Precisely when they need them. Feel free to pay a visit when you find yourself in need of flowers, perhaps to win a lady's heart, or say if the king plans to behead you and you wish to present the queen with flowers in the hope of swaying her to convince the king to spare you. Those sorts of occasions are what I consider valid reasons to purchase flowers from my shop. Hey, lady, I think you maybe need to seek help. Okay, so this is the guild. Is the guild? Yeah, the craftsman is not present yet, but he has some goodies. Nothing really too crazy. Armor 14, good god. But, oof, 10,000 gold. Yeah, no, that's a little bit beyond us. And this is just the regular stuff, and it looks like they go up to tier 3. Excellent quality. Okay. I mean, it's some beefy stuff. We've got the, I think Brunhilde has tier 3 armor on. Yeah. I do very much like the quality grades like that in games. Come back after you've learned the advanced haggling skill. My friend, I wouldn't haggle if my life depended on it. You know what? This town's crazy. It often feels like I'm the only one here not engaged in trade. It's become a local obsession. I can't deny the expert haggling teacher residing here is undoubtedly the most proficient in the entire Amberland. Okay. I'd like haggling. Haggling would save me money. I am broke. I have basic. Do we know where advanced is? We don't know where advanced is. Okay, so we know where expert is. And we're getting there. I assume that this is the magic shop where I go to blow all the fairy dust that I've been hoarding. Yes, crystals. I have 27. We can get vials and a black plate armor. Holy god. I would almost, damn, it's a shame we don't have fucking 30 of the friggin' things. I'd get the black helm and the black plate for swell. Boots of levitation are 25. Girdle of carrying increases max encumbrance by 10. Good lord. The thing with this is I think that if I got this black plate and the black helm, that's probably what swell would be wearing for the rest of the game. Because defensively, he would be just absolutely impervious. I mean, he's only got a 30 and he's already got, you know, 60% resistance until 20 to 29th level monsters, which I don't think we've seen anything in that range. We've seen 20 and then we've seen 40. I think the beholders and the dragon were 40. I'm curious what 50th level things are. This may be like the final boss or something. The ultimate cloak of resistance, cloak of flames. Man. And then, yeah, the stat bruise. Welcome, welcome to our stunning and prosperous town, which is the hub of trade, where you can buy practically anything you desire. Believe it or not, we even have a magic shop. Yes, you heard that correctly. They exclusively accept payment in crystals, as if gold isn't good enough. We can overlook that detail. Their merchandise is truly exquisite. So, go ahead and spend. Now, maybe once they get their craftsmen back, we'll be back to purchase some goods. This is the Riverfell Armed Post South. Thanks, buddy. I want to go poking around, but I have a feeling these barbarians are probably pretty dangerous for naked men, so we're going to leave them alone. There's an island here. I missed this. What have we here? All these little islands like this? They totally make me think that there's gotta be a shovel or something hidden somewhere. And we're gonna be able to dig up all kinds of goodies. Okay. We're back, we've got levels, and we're pissed. Also, I'm lost. Over here. Okay. Alright. So, oh, here we go. Detailed information. Look at that! They have fire resistance, but doesn't appear to be weak to anything. That's a shame. Okay, cool. Really, buddy? Can't use magic. Oh, that's okay. I don't care. Let's try hitting them with a cold ball. Let's see. No, okay. I wanted to see if hitting it with a cold ball would update the log and be like, oh, they're also weak to ice magic. How about you guys? Nope, same thing. So that is a hell of a damage range. This for the melees. Lightning, kill. Heal. Ugh. Alright, we're gonna blow specials on these guys, I think. Pull back just so that I can heal. It's curious to me that in, like, Might and Magic and stuff, you know, you have a party of six, this has a party of seven, but they only let us fight two things at a time. Oh, really? I mean, even in Might and Magic, I want to say it was three in Might and Magic 3 and Zine. I'm not going to count, you know, Might and Magic 1 and 2, because those games, you could fight ridiculous numbers of enemies. I think it Might and Magic 2 is, you could have a fight against up to 256 enemies at a time, which was glorious. Don't get me wrong, because you'd have the really like jank overland encounters like Orcon and stuff, where it was an orc convention. I love it, but very silly. Probably wouldn't be as appreciated by gamers nowadays for the doofy bullshit that we kind of dealt with way back in the day. The whimsy of old shitty DOS RPGs. I do miss it sometime. One of these days I may play Might and Magic 1, but God, that game is painful. Until you get Disintegrate. Once you get Disintegrate, that game is over, because the spell is bugged and basically will one-shot any enemy in the game. Which is hilarious, of course, but it kind of takes all the challenge out, I suppose. Not mean to full heal my party again, but we are gonna... Oh, I want to fight one more. Probably, I was gonna say a little grub, because I'm gonna rest for mana, but I would like these guys to focus so that they can get even more spell points. I'm not gonna rest for mana, I'm gonna rest for hit points. Quick rest there, and now they'll be able to focus again and get even more mana, which I'm probably going to do on this fight. There we go. I really like that they gave the mages the ability to just friggin' regain their mana, because fuck you, we're wizards. It's pretty great. Okay, is it just you? It's pretty noticeable how much more readily we're butchering these things. At least the basic crimson beetles. The melees alone, it seems at this point, are pretty capable of just cutting them down. All right, that's this little chunk emptied out. There are so many bugs in this cave. Good lord. I really do like that the Bard Song also gives you both health and mana. That, coupled with the focus on the mage, actually, I feel gives us quite a bit of staying power when we need to kind of pull out the stops, so to speak. Such a waste of mana to lightning bolt that thing. Crest of Summer. I don't want to sleep on my inventory. What do we got? Crest of Summer, fire resistance. Okay. Sure. Well, I'd equip it, but man, I detest juggling gear in games like this for specific fights. It's just such a pain in the ass. It is far too much work for essentially, you know, we're gonna fight something with fire, and I can't even be like, oh, it's terrible game design, because I don't think it is, and it's something that I'm planning on probably doing in Cud Crawler. It's just something that as a player, it's too much for me to remember. Like, one of the reasons I like these games is because, by and large, I can kind of turn my brain off and just hack my way through crowds of enemies, and it's nice. But when I start having to worry about, you know, oh, does everybody hit, I don't know, the resistance threshold for this raid, or are they going to get one shot by the AoEs because they're scrubby, it kind of changes how I approach things and it ceases being fun. Optional fights? Sure. The dragon fight? Yeah, I'm going to go into that. I'm going to equip my party expecting, you know, fire damage. So I will build everybody to have fire resistance and stuff. But for random dungeon encounters, that's a bit much for me. Just a bit. These suckers, massive fire AoEing my party. Oh, let's see. And then a regular heal. There we go. He tells this guy gonna come back. No. There are just so many of them. It is incredible. Okay. I think I saw two of them over here. Did I? I did. Sneaky little shit. Nice try. Mithril longsword, that could be something. And then we've got the challenge over there. 125 damage. Okay, that's nothing really too particularly interesting if I'm being honest. It's light, but I assume that's just because it's made of mithril. Okay, let's kill you. I'm gonna hold off on recovery. I was tempted, but no, I'll have the bard song go though. Come on, guys. God damn it. Kill the. Oh my god. Such a waste of mana. Such a waste of mana. Ooh, that was mean. Rove almost died. Go. All right, is that? And that's everything for this floor. Now we have whatever hell awaits us down here. Do we have more info? Nope. It's the mountains that divide the realm of Bardachia and the southern islands. All right, well, I think I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time we're in Bug Caves Continue. Until then. Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching.